This signaled a new era and direction, marked by performances of some of classical music's most beloved heroes. Some names you might recognize are Johannes Brahms, Niccolo Paganini, Franz Liszt, and our favorite Clara and Robert Schumann. In March 1829, this new hall hosted one of the most iconic concerts in classical music history. A 20-year-old Felix Mendelssohn, who was the grandson of one of the founding members of the Singing Academy, conducted a performance of J.S. Bach's St. Matthew's Passion. This performance is often pointed to as the spark for the Bach Renaissance, which brought the great master's work back into vogue and ensured its place of prominence in the musical canon. The performance was attended by all of the movers and shakers of the time. King Frederick Wilhelm IV, the Prussian nobility, and all of the royal family were in attendance, along with many intellectual leaders. With a plethora of performances given at the Singing Academy, a collection of sheet music naturally began to accumulate. As a former student of C.P.E. Bach, Zelter had access to music written by his teacher and his teacher's other pupils. Similarly, Sarah Levy, an active member of the Singing Academy, had studied with one of Bach's sons, Wilhelm Friedrich. She was the fifth child of 15 children born to a Jewish family in Berlin. Her father, Daniel Itzig, was a banker for the king, who had distinguished himself by financing the Seven Years' War against Austria. Daniel was given many special privileges to operate in society that were not generally afforded to other Jews at the time. Aside from the prestige of his occupation, his shrewd business dealings brought him much wealth. This allowed his children to be exposed to the very best musical teaching. Sarah Itzig, Daniel's daughter, eventually married a man named Samuel Levy, and as they had no children, Sarah remained extremely devoted to the arts as a performer and as a patron. Aside from giving many solo and chamber music performances at the Singing Academy, she is credited with commissioning a number of works by C.P.E. Bach, her former teacher, Wilhelm Friedrich, and their contemporaries. Upon retiring from performance, Sarah left her extraordinary collection of original scores and performance editions to the Singing Academy. Bella Itzig, sister to Sarah, had two children with her husband. Their daughter Leah married Abraham Mendelssohn, the son of the great German Enlightenment philosopher Moses Mendelssohn, and Leah and Abraham's children are Felix and Fanny Mendelssohn, whom you might recognize for their compositions. After Leah and Abraham Mendelssohn were married, they moved to Hamburg at the same time in which C.P.E. Bach's daughter, Anna Carolina, died. She had been left with the entire Bach estate, and after her death, the estate was offered up for auction. Abraham and Leah bought the majority of the music in the estate and donated it to the library of the Singing Academy. Professor Christoph Wolff noted the significance of this purchase and acquisition for the legacy of Bach's music. Mendelssohn's acquisition of the Bach estate, which included not only the complete works of C.P.E. Bach, but also a significant portion of the surviving works of J.S. Bach, represented a genuine rescue operation with respect to the latter's music. It's important for the survival of J.S. Bach's music, contained in more than 100 unique autograph scores, must not be underestimated, and it is safe to say that without Abraham Mendelssohn's efforts, the losses of Bach's music would be significantly greater than what we have to deplore already. Abraham and Leah Mendelssohn, along with Zelter and Sarah Levy, are responsible for much of the library of the Berlin Singing Academy. Without these Bach devotees, it is possible that the manuscripts of J.S. Bach and his sons would not be known to us. Their commitment to securing scores, serious study, and regular performance of these works committed many of our campus pieces to the central repertoire of classical music. It's fascinating to note that three of the four aforementioned characters were practicing Jews who worked tirelessly to preserve and promote the music of a decidedly Protestant Christian. After a number of directors, George Schumann took charge of the Berlin Singing Academy in the year 1900 and brought the tradition of choral performance into modernism. In programming the works of Cesar Franck, Giuseppe Verdi, Franz Liszt, Anton Bruckner, and Max Reger, the Singing Academy had achieved a new role in the musical fabric of Berlin. 13 years after his tenure began, George Schumann began to take the Singing Academy on tour in Europe. For all of the widespread acclaim and modernization George Schumann brought to the Singing Academy, he will most rightly be remembered for his efforts to preserve the institution through the perils of living through Nazi Germany during World War II. One of his shrewd plans was to link the Singing Academy with the Prussian Academy of Arts. In joining them together, he left special language in the bylaws to ensure judicial independence for the Singing Academy. faced multiple days of red tape at the library in Kiev, who claimed that the archives were currently under construction. After much persistence, the director took the threesome into the archives where he pulled a cardboard box off the shelf. Dr. Wolf opened the lid and found bound scores with the Berlin City Academy seal affixed to the front. This is what he had been searching for the previous 20 years of his career. Dr. Wolf returned to Kiev to have a better look through the archive with the help of his colleagues from the Bach Archive in Leipzig. In the collection, Dr. Grimstead reported that they found more than 500 scores from Bach family members, most of George Philipp Thalmann's works, brothers Karl Heinrich and Johann Gottlieb Graun, Adolf Hasse, along with compositions by King Frederick II of Prussia, George Friedrich Handel, and Franz Joseph Haydn. The miracle